अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर फर्स्ट वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। टुडे वी विल डू द लेफ्ट ओवर वर्क ऑफ योर सिलेबस। सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 128, ग्रामर सेक्शन, इन विच वी हैव टू मेक सेंटेंस बाय यूजिंग द पास्ट टेंस एज वेल एज पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस। सो इन पेज नंबर 129 you can see the complete the following sentence. Each sentence should contain both the simple past tense and past perfect tense. So in these sentence we have to use the past tense, simple past tense, as well as past perfect tense. The first sentence is, yesterday I gave the essay to my teacher. Although I hadn't checked the mistakes. So you see, there are two, we have used two tenses in the same sentence. The first one is simple past tense and the second one is past perfect tense. We use the two tenses, that is past perfect and past perfect, simple past tense in a sentence when two action took place in a past, and we want to tell that which action has taken, which action has been done in first place. This same way, my blue bike hit the ground when a dog crossed the road. Number third one, she understood the movie as she had read the novel before. Here we are telling that she had already read the novel, and that's why she understood the movie. Although he had prepared for test, he didn't do well. Before I went to Goa, I had made reservation in hotel. Number sixth one, by the time I reached station, train had already left the station. At 12 noon, I heard a blast after I had my brunch. With his bag over his shoulder, he jumped over the fence as he had a bad day at home. On the other side of the road, the man crossed the road after the car had hit the pole. Now we are doing the second section of this page 129, that is B, in which fill each blank with the correct form of the bracket of the verb in bracket. And you can see that the verbs are given in brackets, so we have to use the correct form of the verb. Now we are starting from chapter Scale. As soon as Tim finished his homework, he rushed off to the tennis court. Alice starts on the new job from tomorrow. I bought the vegetable yesterday, so they should still be quite fresh. Don't interrupt your sister while she is studying. You can make the sentence like, don't interrupt your sister while she studies. I will come if my parents don't object. Jenny has seen the play already and she says it's very good. I was thinking about Jim when all of a sudden he walked into the room. There were four of them. I had seen one of them before. Let me know as soon as Ray arrives. If Suzanne comes, will she bring her sister with her? This is the exercise B of page 129. Now, we are starting a new chapter, and the chapter name is The World in Your Room. The World in Your Room. This chapter is about the modern gadgets we used and how the things are modifying. in how the things will modify in future. The text looks at the way future technology might affect our lives and the way we communicate. This chapter discusses the possibility of more sophisticated mobile phones that can, for example, remind us that important events are about to start, or gadgets that connect with our thought or physical conditions such as warmth or cold. It also looks at virtual reality and how a single book might physically change its content. For example, it's from the history book may be changed into TV guide at the press of a button, or more, and maybe a mind reading bed come chairs of which can understand your mood and can play the music for you if you are in sad mood or if you are in fun, in joyful mood. So these are the modern gadgets which will work according to your mood, according to your requirement. Just like the carpets that care, a carpet that will clean by it itself. You don't have to clean the carpet, and also they will tell if somebody who is unfamiliar came into the house. So such sort of gadget which may be maybe a part of our life in future. This chapter is all about that. Now we are moving to the vocabulary section. In vocabulary section, we are studying about the words whose origin is from Greek or from Latin. So we have to find the origin of these words from the text. The words is photograph. The photograph is the origin. Photograph's origin is Greek. It has come from the Greek, and photo means light and graphicos means drawing or pictures. The second one is telephone. Tele is also a Greek word which means far off. Phone, that means voices. So these words in English has been taken from other language. Mobile is a Latin word, mobilis, which means movable. Gizmo is American English, which means something you can't give a name to. Computer, Latin words, which means to count or sum up. Audio, which is the Latin word audere, means hear. Stereophonic, that is stereos, Greek, which means solid. And phone means voice. Chatbot, chatter, that is Dutch words which means Twitter, gossip, and also means verb. Camera is a Latin word. Canon, in canna is a Latin word which means tube. Trom is a Middle Flemish meaning beam, handle of a bar or rung. Truck, trochila, meaning small wheel or pulley. Now from moving on from there, we are going to the next page, which is 141. Okay, in 141 we have lots of words, but before that let me tell you this is for today, and inshallah in next class we will discuss about the different aspect of the technology and conditional clauses. Thank you for listening. Till then, it's Allah Hafiz. Bye bye.